Our isolation is now our best defence. An island within an island. Our own country.
In an era when premiers became cult figures, the Premier of Western Australia stood out.
McGowan!
Hero to many.
You know, responsible.
But not all.
I just feel so just devastated. I just don't know when this is going to end.
His premiership defined by COVID.
I'm getting criticised for saying I prefer not to have COVID.
It would be reckless and irresponsible to open up now.
And the odd kebab.
I'm eating a kebab.
There's nothing wrong with going for a run and having a kebab.
As other states went in and out of lockdowns, saw borders open and close, Fortress WA stood firm to all critics.
I just don't think it's logical at this stage to maintain those border closures for a prolonged period of time.
New South Wales had the Ruby Princess. I mean, seriously? And they're trying to give us advice on our borders?
7 out of 8 states and territories want us to get back to that.
I think some of the commentators might hang out on the North Shore of Sydney, drinking their lattes and sipping their Pinot Grigio. And I don't think they have any clue about what goes on here.
McGowan hitting a whopping 91% approval rate.
Mark McGowan's features now a permanent fixture on this Scarborough man's leg.
I'm not getting it removed, it's the best.
Mark McGowan, I'm in love, I'd do anything for you in your hard, hard, hard border.
That hard border, the cornerstone to what became a landslide 2021 election win.
A complete not a landslide, there's no other word for it.
As the rest of Australia moved to a new COVID normal, McGowan delayed.
Western Australia's border rules will remain until around 90% of the population over 12 is fully vaccinated.
National Cabinet agreed the plan.
Yeah, that's not the plan.
You're actually putting a price on Australians.
I don't believe keeping your borders closed and inflicting pain and suffering on thousands of people is the way to go.
Let us who?
In January, another delay.
Western Australia's decision to backflip on its border reopening, leaving the state cut off from the rest of the country indefinitely.
The tourism industry is reeling from the news.
The damage to the Western Australian economy in the long term from this decision will be huge.
But COVID finally broke through.
Despite his popularity taking a hit, as local cases surge, Mark McGowan denies the hard borders become redundant.
We've done everything that we've been asked to do. As far as we're concerned at this point, the only person that's gone back on his word is Mark McGowan.
Earlier this month, Fortress WA finally came down, the end of an extraordinary chapter.
No good to have her. Mr. Smell.
2.5 years, yeah, so it's everything, which is a long, long time, but it's beautiful.
Our reputation will be as the safest jurisdiction in the world that handled COVID the best in the world.
Premier Mark McGowan joins us now. Welcome. Thank you for letting us in and for turning on the weather.
You're welcome.
Spectacular. Cooler than it has been, by all accounts.
It's certainly a beautiful day, but it's a classic West Australian day.
These guys are loving being here. Yeah. I think we've got to get a tracking device that they don't stay here for good. They are so impressed with it. We'd love to have you.
You've got tracking devices to make sure we go home as opposed to getting in? That's the thing?
Yeah. A week. We'll give you a week. We don't overcrowd it.
Okay, we're so glad that we are a country again, especially as someone that's got family over here. There was periods where people joked about how you guys might cut us off for good over in the East Coast. There was never a genuine thought, was there, of perhaps going separate ways?
Not serious. We did what we had to do in the circumstances we faced. Obviously, we've had a very good set of outcomes, a very soft landing, if you like, out of COVID, and that's because we kept it out, we got to very high levels of vaccination, we had very few people pass away, less than 10 people in Western Australia pass away who acquired the virus here, and great economic outcomes. So, you know, and I know it caused a lot of grief for a lot of people, for instance, you, me.
I'm okay, but there was people in obviously lots
worse
situations.
My family in the East, I couldn't see them for a while. But we did what was the best outcome for an isolated state that could keep the virus out.
I think WA would have to be right up there of levels of vaccination across the world, which is what you encourage the residents to do, and everyone followed your lead. Then when you delayed the border opening, have you reflected, or at the time, did you feel like that you were sort of doing an about face or being somewhat untrue to what you'd promoted?
Not really. What we did was we delayed it a month. And what that allowed was our third dose rate go from about 25% to nearly 70%. So by doing that, we actually saved a great many lives. And we also stopped some of the, you know, terrible economic consequences that occurred over East. So since April, I think it was, of 2020, we've actually only had 12 days of lockdown in WA. And I know in Victoria you've had hundreds, and New South Wales 150 or so. So, but by delaying it that month, we actually got that third dose rate up to the highest vaccination rate, certainly in Australia, perhaps by the ACT, and potentially around the world.
What's interesting, though, is that the numbers took off even before the border was opened. So I just wonder, and then, of course, we've seen since the numbers have continued to explode. So do you think the border in the end made that much difference? Like, if you'd opened when you said you would, the virus was already in at that point.
It was. It was growing very slowly. So what South Australia, for instance, did, they opened back in, I think it was November last year. Suddenly, within weeks, they had thousands of thousands of cases, whereas we didn't do that. So we avoided that whilst that third dose climbed. And so now we're at 75 or so percent third dose. We're at over 99% first dose, over 98% second dose. So just that little bit of a delay basically meant we got to that extremely high level, and that reduced the pressure on our hospitals, it reduced the number of people dying, it reduced the economic outcomes. As you can see, you know, our community, but for mask wearing, is largely pretty free.
As someone who travels a bit myself, can you just clarify, are border closures a thing of the past?
Yeah, we don't have any plans to bring it back in. Obviously, if some other virus comes in that has some terrible, you know, health outcomes, you can't ever rule it out, and I think people would understand that. But no, because our vaccination rate now is so high, we don't need to think about it again at this point in time.
Bro, you've been asked a lot of questions recently about your relationship with the Prime Minister. I get the impression, judging by this vision, that you're a bit over it. Let's have a look.
Do you think Anthony Albanese will be annoyed today, though, and his federal MPs, that you've stood up alongside Scott Morrison?
Were you offended by the Prime Minister's cave people comment?
Do you like Scott Morrison? He often talks about how good your working relationship is.
I mean, this body language there. So what is your relationship like with Scott Morrison?
That was fine. Professional. You know, my role as Premier is to get the best outcome for the state. And if they're going to make budget announcements giving us hundreds of millions or billions of dollars, of course, you know, you try and get that. But obviously, I'll be supporting Anthony Albanese. I'll be supporting our federal Labor team in the election campaign when it comes up, as I always do.
That sounds like when a partner says, I'm fine, and they don't really, they're not really fine.
It's interesting you say that because, of course, we read in the West Australian today there are some people in Labor ranks who think you haven't been giving enough love to Anthony Albanese. You're a bit closer with Scott Morrison, at least in the way you're presenting publicly. Is there a bit of tension there?
No, it's actually not true. He's the Prime Minister, so obviously if they're going to make big announcements here that fund large parts of the projects the state government is putting forward, I'll go and support that because that's the best thing for the state. But clearly, I've known Anthony for a long period of time. He's a very decent person. I think he'd be a very good Prime Minister. And I'll support our federal Labor team, as I have going back to when Bob Hawke was Prime Minister, when I first started handing out how to votes.
You mentioned the South Australia election and the border reopening before December. We saw what happened on the weekend. And you believe that is because they opened the border too soon, that Marshall lost?
I think it's one of the consequences. Obviously, they opened, then they had this mass outbreak, they had terrible economic outcomes, and they had a lot of people die. And I think people would have said, well, you know, you opened when you didn't have to, and why'd you do that? And so I think that would be a lot of South Australians would have thought that. But there's other factors as well. Obviously, the opposition leader, the Labor leader in South Australia, was pretty spectacular. And I think the Labor team ran a very disciplined and very focused campaign, which paid dividends.
So when you say he's spectacular, do you mean this photo that I was widely seen? Is that what you're referring to? And then what worried me is that photo obviously went around. Then there was the photo of you in a similar sort of situation. This was your response. Not that, clearly.
That is piss weak.
You mean secure? Is that what explains that?
I think he makes all middle-aged men feel a bit down. But anyway, he's actually a very nice man and very decent, very focused. I spoke to him in December. You know, he wanted to work all through Christmas, every day, every night, to try and win that election.
He got his wife in the speech too. Did you see that?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah,
he's made a big faux pas there. But he's you know, he's a very decent, hard-working guy. So, and as you can see, he has time to go to the gym as well.
Well, I reckon you're hard-working because you were literally working in the pool. I mean, you were still in work clothes.
I was actually working in the pool.
Right.